friends, I am back with a quick gentle flow that you might do in the morning before starting your day, before going off to work or to school, or really it doesn't have to be done in the morning. Anytime you just want to take a shorter period of time to do a little bit of moving that's not going to be too strenuous, but to maybe wake up some body parts and get some stretching in, get some movement in, just to feel a little bit more energized for your day. And I'm going to face sideways for a good part of this opening sequence, so it might be helpful for you too as well. You don't necessarily have to, but make sure you have a little space around you. All right, so the first thing we're going to try is putting hands or just fingertips kind of on the shoulders and doing some big circles, reaching the elbows out wide and up and around. Do a few in one direction. And let's switch directions. Lightly put our hands behind the head. You don't necessarily have to grab hold in any way, just kind of lightly having your hands behind your head. From here, we'll do a twist in one direction. I'm going to go to the right, and I'm just kind of seeing how far I can go without my hands helping. And then I will go ahead and kind of extend my arms to more of a usual position that we might do in this sort of twisted yoga where we've got a hand to a leg and a hand behind us. And then I'll come back to my hands behind the head position and try the other side. First without using the hands and just kind of seeing how far I can go. And then reaching my arms into place for help. Coming back up with the hands, back to center. Let's do a couple more from side to side. Last one. Okay, and then from here, from this position, I am going to interlace my fingers behind my head and kind of grab hold of it just a little bit. We'll do a little cat-cow-ish movement, mostly kind of upper spine, but don't be overly concerned with what all is moving. So we'll inhale and kind of lift up, reach up, get a little bit more back than me. Then as we exhale, you can kind of have your elbows in and around, downward just a little bit. We'll keep it small to start, and then we'll add a variation and add a little bit more depth. So from here, next time we come up, instead of having hands clasped behind the head, let's grab opposite elbows overhead if possible. Maybe grab forearms if bringing them a little closer feels like it's too much. And we'll continue with cat-cow movement, but see if you can like increase how much you're going there. Maybe getting a little bit more arched in your back here, and then a little bit more round, and maybe even draw your forearms down towards your legs a little bit into more of a fold. Let's try that back and forth. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. One more time. Okay, let's lift up and we'll release the arms. And just for good measure, let's switch the cross of the legs because we can do that sometimes. That can feel different for our hips. All right, so we'll do a little bit of movement here from this position. Reaching the arms forward, and then I'm going to let one arm draw more forward so the shoulder blade protracts and kind of goes outward, and then I'll let it pull in and let the other one go forward. And I'll just kind of
trying to really move from the shoulders to start, and then we'll start to increase and add on what we're doing with this here. All right, so then we're gonna keep doing that thing with the arms. We start to let ourselves come forward, thinking a neutral-ish spine. It might round a little bit, and that's okay. Just kind of going as far as we can until we feel a little something and we feel like we get stuck. And then we'll start to kind of lean back a little bit. Might feel the core muscles kind of kicking in for help so we don't fall backward. Let's go back and forth a couple more times. I know that even my arms are getting tired. And then next time we're reaching forward, we'll go ahead and kind of rest down in somewhat of a fold here for a breath. And then let's walk this upright. Okay, I'm gonna uncross the legs and keep the knees bent and just kind of have your feet out in front of you. And we're gonna try to do just a little bit of a balance here in this shape. You can round your back a little bit, hang on to your legs, kind of squeeze them together. So you can kind of rock your weight back and maybe even tuck your chin a little bit and curl into a little, kind of like a little balancing ball here, right? You can always keep your feet down if you feel like that's too much, but we're gonna see if we can transition back and forth from this sort of like knee hug balance thing into some other positions, a few different ones, okay. So the first one we're gonna try is a deer pose position. So I'm gonna kind of windshield wiper and open the legs and kind of send them over to one side. And they're at similar degrees of bend. The exact amount is up to you. And we'll kind of reach forward in a little bit of a fold and maybe feel a little interesting stretchiness. And then we'll come back up. And I'm gonna kind of reach behind me and back a bit until I feel a little something interesting in the hip area on the opposite side. And then I'll come back up and I'll come back to my little balancing knee hug. And then I'm gonna switch sides for that deer pose type of thing. Knees kind of windshield wiper. Try a little reach forward. Come up. All right, kind of reach out and back, and up. Let's come back to that little knee balance. Let's do that one more time each side. Deer pose, little fold. Come back up, and then we'll kind of twist and reach back, and come back up. Lift back to our little knee hug. Again, you could have your feet down if that felt better. Switch sides for deer. Do a little reach forward and come up and then reach over and back and come up. And then let's come back to that knee hug. All right, so we're gonna do kind of a similar thing but a different pose. And this time instead of deer pose, it'll be head to knee pose. So one leg will be straight and the opposite leg will be sort of tree pose-like. And we'll reach toward the straight leg and then lift back up into that little balance and then switch and reach and fold. Let's try that a few times. One of those, and then from this little balance position, I'm going to take my legs out wide and reach forward just a bit and then lift back up. And of course, whatever your floor surface is, if you've got carpet, it may not work as well to slide like I'm doing, so you can kind of feel like you can do what you need to do to help yourself with that. It doesn't have to be exactly what I'm doing. Okay, and then from this
wide-legged folded position. I'm going to do a little bit of kind of sweeping into some side bends from side to side. So I'll kind of reach toward one leg, take the opposite arm up and sort of turn upward, and then take it down and over to the other side. And lift and turn upward. Let's try a few more. Okay, we'll come back to center in our wide-legged position. And let's come back to that knee hug, but let's keep our feet down and just kind of take a rest. You can put your arms on top of your legs and take your head down. All right, from here, you're going to transition into a table position, hands and knees, all fours. And we're going to do some alternating between positions here. So let's keep the toes tucked under the whole time, and we'll think neutral spine, best we can feel. It doesn't have to be perfect. We're going to do a similar thing to those arm reaches where the shoulder blades move, keeping your arms straight, and see if maybe the elbows can kind of spin forward. All right, squeeze the shoulder blades together and then spread them apart. And after that, send your hips back towards your heels until you feel a little stretch in your feet. And then we'll come back up to table and do another round of the scapular movement, the shoulder blade movement, and then get to the feet. Let's keep going. We're going to add on this time. After sitting back into our little kind of foot stretch, we'll lift the knees up into downward dog, and it might be approximate, it might not be exactly how you normally do downward dog, but that's okay. Take it back down to table from there, and then shoulder blade movement, press into the feet, press up to down dog, down to table. Shoulder blades draw together, spread apart. Sit back into the feet. Press up to down dog. Back to table. Shoulder blades retract and protract. Toe tuck, push into the feet. Lift up to down dog. This time, let's just take a moment to maybe wiggle a little bit in our down dog. Walk the hands back toward the feet until we are in a forward fold position. Got my feet about hip width. You can adjust your width to whatever feels best for you. Knees might bend a little bit. And let's see if we can grab elbows like we did earlier, but hopefully it feels a little bit easier here in this position. And we're going to take this and do a little bit of swaying from side to side. And the next time you're going to the right, let's keep lifting all the way up, kind of circling up to standing, and then circling down and over to the left, back down into that fold. Let's go to the left first, lifting all the way up and over, down and over to the right, and coming back down. All right, go ahead and release hold of your elbows. And then let's walk it back forward into table from here. And then from that table position, let's look to kneeling. And you can keep your toes tucked or you can release your toes however that feels best for you. All right, so we're going to do a little bit of kind of back and forth here as well. All right, let's take the arms up. And it might feel somewhat camel-like, but don't overdo. The arching in your back might think a little squeeze for the glutes and think tailbone down. All right, from that arms up position, let's kind of try to face the left as we reach our arms wide. All right, from here, I'm gonna let my right hand come down until I'm in sort of like a one arm up table. And then that takes me into a thread the needle, reaching that arm under and taking just a breath there. And then I'll push back into that right hand.
and reach back up, lifting the right hand back to my wide arm position, and then reaching back up from kneeling. And then I'll turn to the right, arms wide, taking the left hand down and a table arm up, reaching under for thread in the needle. Take a breath. Press back up. Lift up arms wide. And then face forward, both arms up. And then if you're kind of feeling the whole camel thing and want to do a different variation, maybe reach for your heels, maybe just reach your hands on your back or your hips somewhere. Take a moment. All right, let's come back to table. From here, and you may need to move some things just to make space, I'm gonna take my right knee forward and kind of angle it more to the right as my foot comes to the left for like a pigeon type of leg. And I'll walk those left toes back a bit. And then walk things upright as much as you can. Feel a little extension. Walk it forward into a little bit more of a fold. Walk your hands over to one side in that fold for a little side reach. Let's try walking it over to the opposite side, side reach. Back to center, walking it back up. Maybe we kind of scoot that back knee in again and then come back to table. Let's try the other side. Left knee comes forward and over, right knee scoots back. Walk it up a little bit, extend, walk it forward. Fold. Walk your fold over to one side, a little side reach. Walk it over to the other side, little side reach. That feels yummy for me on this side. Walk it back to center and up. Scoot that right knee back in a little bit. Back to table. And then let's go into child's pose from there. Maybe you widen your knees a bit, just kind of rest down for a moment. Check your breathing. So much for joining me, and I look forward to practicing with you again soon. Have a good one.